It may seem silly to even ask the question, but can plants think? Some scientists think they do. Hi guys, Lisette here for DNews. I know you're thinking this sounds like a secret plot to turn you against vegetarians, but plants have the ability to remember and process information and even do things like count and communicate. A recent study published in the journal Current Biology found that Venus flytraps track and remember the number of times an insect touches the plant's trigger hairs, or hair-like mechanosensors in the flytrap's mouth. When an insect lands on a Venus flytrap and doesn't move, this single stimulation will lead to pretty much nothing. But if the insect moves a second time within the next 20 seconds, the Venus flytrap will shut. On the third movement sense, the plant will begin to ooze out digestive acids. And the more the insect moves, the more acid it will release. This is significant because it requires the Venus flytrap to hold on to information and essentially remember the number of times it's received a specific stimulus and then respond appropriately. If a second movement isn't detected before 20 seconds, the Venus flytrap will essentially reset. This helps it differentiate between raindrops and wind and an actual meal. Now, that sounds like one smart plant, but it's not alone. There are a lot of plants out there that can do some pretty smart things. In fact, some may be even communicating with each other. You may have heard your mother tell you to put that ripe apple by the green ones in order to ripen them. Well, the reason this works is that when a fruit like an apple starts to ripen, it secretes a natural hormone called ethylene, and other nearby fruits pick up on this and begin to ripen as well. Acacia trees seem to communicate in a similar way. When antelope graze on them, acacia trees also release this chemical and other non-affected trees pick up on it. These alerted trees then produce tannins that make the leaves poisonous to the antelope. Some plants can even detect these predators before they bite. When researchers at the University of Missouri played sounds of caterpillars munching leaves to mustard plants, the mustard plants responded by releasing mustard oil, which is deadly to caterpillars. The plants did not respond this way to regular old wind sounds. It was specifically the sound of caterpillars eating leaves that caused the mustard plant to defend itself. With somewhere between 15 and 20 different senses to absorb and respond to other cues from their environment, plants start to seem almost as smart as some lower animals. This is what Darwin suggests. So plants can hear predators coming, smell when they're nearby, count the number of times their leaves have been touched, and they even seem to get cues from their neighbors about what's going on to increase their chances of surviving. All these responses and cell-to-cell communication are what some scientists go as far as calling intelligent behavior. But how smart do plants seem to you? Have you ever kept one as a pet? Sound off in the comments below, and to learn why some plants evolved to eat animals, check out Julie and Julian's awesome video here.
While their diets mostly consist of things that crawl, occasionally a small rodent or reptile will take the bait and become plant food. Trapping an insect is tricky, so there's not just one way to do it. There's actually about 5 main ways to go about catching a meal.
Thanks for watching DNews. Remember to like and subscribe for more videos.